Tetanus, diphtheria vaccines show promise against COVID-19, studies show. COVID-19 vaccines are specifically made to prevent severe disease, especially in those at risk. But what about other vaccines? Can they do anything to reduce the impact of the coronavirus? The question isn't new, and some research groups actually made studies to find insights. For example, the BCG vaccine for tuberculosis was suggested to enhance the innate immune response to subsequent infections, according to Medical News Today. However, its real-world effects against COVID are yet to be fully determined. The vaccines in those studies were live attenuated, which contained weakened pathogens to induce an immune response. So newer studies investigated inactivated vaccines that contained killed microbes to do the same result. These studies examined if inactivated vaccines might protect people from SARS-CoV-2, or if they could lead to cross-reactivity to the coronavirus. In a 2020 study in Frontiers in Immunology, researchers concluded that vaccines for meningitis B, diphtheria, tetanus, and pertussis might confer SARS-CoV-2 protection in children. The vaccines were deemed to trigger cross-reactivity to the virus. Cross-reactivity refers to an immune response, originally triggered by a pathogen, that reacts against an unrelated pathogen. A 2021 study published in Medical Hypothesis found something too. Researchers used artificial intelligence to model the cross-reactivity of the tetanus vaccine to COVID-19. The AI identified signs that a vaccine may contribute to the reduced severity of the disease. A more recent study, uploaded in MedRxiv for peer review, analyzed the immunization records and COVID-19 testing data of more than 103,000 people using the UK Biobank. Based on those details and additional factors, such as an underlying respiratory illnesses and socioeconomic status, those who received DTP vaccine boosters were less likely to get a positive SARS-CoV-2 test. Moreover, those who got their tetanus boosters were half as likely to develop severe COVID, while those who received their diphtheria booster were 54% less likely to meet the same outcome. But for pertussis boosters, researchers found no statistical differences in the chances of getting a positive test or severe disease. The findings of these studies were based on observable association, as researchers couldn't prove the cause and effect. Like other experts, they couldn't fully explain why the association between vaccines and COVID-19 appeared. To understand the connection completely, scientists must unravel the complex mysteries of the immune system. For now, science can offer this. The immune system can recall past encounters and use memories to better engage them in the future. Yeah.